On April 8th, 1994, Nirvana leader Kurt Cobain's body was discovered at his house in Seattle, where he committed suicide. How do fans, friends, and other performers feel about the singer and songwriter a year later? We asked around.
The thing that affects me personally a lot is that there just aren't any more songs. He's not going to write any more new songs. He's not going to make any more new records. And I think that's a genuine loss.
It was just kind of unbelievable. I think it just made me think, you know, how sad it was just that he felt that lost.
I knew what he had meant to the people who had followed that music. So I was just peeping out how, you know, they had lost one of their founders and one of their, you know, their big stars, and how they was kind of bugging. I thought it was a real loss to the musical world because he was a true artist.
Personally, just blew me away that something like that would happen to someone because he was the same age as me. And it was like, that was the first person that I knew in music, like out of my generation, that took that way out, and it really bummed me out because I wondered how someone could get to that point.
Should I be all apologies? What else should I say? Everyone is gay.
When news of Kurt Cobain's suicide spread last April, fans in Seattle gathered together to cope with the tragedy and to remember a musician who touched their lives. One year later, MTV News asked people in Seattle and New York, as well as folks attending a concert in Memphis, Tennessee, about the loss of Cobain and the impact of Nirvana's music.
We were listening to Nirvana on the way over here, and I was hoping, actually, you know, it'd be great. When I said to my girlfriend, I said, what if we could see Nirvana live tonight? And how awesome that would be, because, I mean, Kurt was a great songwriter, and just sad to see him go.
I think that it got a little blown out of proportion, that one man was the total spokesman for all of this music, but he made really good music, and it's definitely lasted beyond him.
Anytime you have people who feel like this person represented me, they're going to talk about him and spread him and cherish him and honor him by keep buying his records. So I think that group is going to be around for a while.
Indeed, three of Nirvana's albums, In Utero, Nevermind, and Unplugged in New York, are currently all on Billboard's Top 200 album chart.
I don't believe that people are just rushing out and buying 3 and 4 copies of Nevermind so they've got them as some sort of tribute. I think what's happening is that people are continually buying them. New people are buying them. They're listening to them. They're hearing them in a different light.
I don't think about it as much anymore, but I still think that he contributed a lot to music, especially around here in Seattle.
It's sad in a way because, you know, I really like the music, and just to think that someone who was doing such a great job at, you know, pulling out some really good sounds and stuff like that wasn't going to be around anymore.
While no one will ever know the full extent to which Kurt Cobain suffered and what led him to suicide, we do know that depression is a serious illness and one that should be treated as such.
People who feel suicidal feel there's no hope, there's no possibility for change, they don't feel they have support, they don't feel that there's any options available to them. And that's why communication is such an important part of suicide prevention. Because when we talk to each other, when we make contact, when we express the things that are going on for ourselves, we get grounded, we get connected. That doesn't solve our problems, but it helps us get through the moment. And that's a very important part of that process.
On Wednesday, former Nirvana drummer Dave Grohl will kick off his first tour with his new band Foo Fighters in Tempe, Arizona, where the group will be opening for Mike Watt, on whose new album Ball Hogger Tugboat Grohl also played. As for Nirvana bassist Chris Novoselic, he's said to be still playing music, but not with any particular band yet. We will keep you posted on that.
Never seen that before.
Nobody's seen this for 100 years.